Hi everyone, welcome to lesson 9 of the essay. The heading for our lesson today is Disinvestment and Sanctions by the AAM. There are two terms here we have to deal with. We have disinvestment, we have also sanctions. Just to make sure that everyone understands the two terms. When we talk about disinvestment, like when a company decides to put its money in a certain country like South Africa, in a term of maybe, in a way of running, say, PEP or whatever, running a certain business in South Africa, when they put their monies, we call that investment. But now when they decide to take their monies out, close the stores, close PEP, that is now disinvestment. All right. So disinvestment really refers to the pulling out of the countries with their monies from this kind of ours. Okay, sanctions. This is a definition, actually. All right, it says, it's a punitive measure to persuade a country to act in a certain way. It's a punitive, from punish. It's a punitive measure to persuade a country to act in a certain way. In this case, to persuade South Africa to end apartheid. As a result, Western countries had invested billions of rands in South Africa. Foreign companies had invested both finance and technology needed by the SA economy. South Africa had cheap labor and abundant resources. The abundant resources, what is meant by that is your minerals, your gold, your diamond. All right. As a result of that, investors really did not wish to withdraw their investments in South Africa. They justified their investment saying that they provided much needed jobs in South Africa. Investors argued that disinvestment would hurt blacks more than the whites, as blacks benefited in the jobs. The AAM put pressure on British companies to withdraw their investments in South Africa. Township unrest also assisted in weakening business confidence in South Africa. Western companies began to pull out their funds from South Africa. Barclays Bank seemed to be delaying this investment, and British supporters of the AAM boycotted Barclays Bank, which had a lot of investment in South Africa. The chairman of the Barclays Bank condemned apartheid as repugnant, wrong, unchristian, and unworkable. Finally, Barclays Bank disinvested, as many other British companies.